They're called safety precautions for a reason. Maybe next time you should try adding some.
The World According to Jon.
Hello and welcome to The World According to Jon. My name is, as you know, Jonathan Paula. Today's story is a tragic and unfortunate one that comes to us from Haaksbergen, the Netherlands, where at an outdoor monster truck rally of sorts, one of these gigantic vehicles, after completing a car-destroying stunt, veered off course, unable to stop, and plunged into the crowd. Dozens were hurt, and at least two people were killed. These video clips that are surfacing today on YouTube, Vimeo, and LiveLeak are disturbing to say the very least, even if they aren't completely graphic. It is haunting to watch these images and realize that some people just had their final moments right there. And at first, you want to blame the driver for not being able to control his vehicle. But then you have to realize what types of vehicles these are. He's driving a 20-year-old monster truck, which didn't have a remote ignition kill switch. So it was up to him to execute a 3-point turn in the amount of space I can barely turn around my small Ford Fiesta. He's driving a 40-foot truck 10 feet off the ground, and he has no space to do it. That's not his fault, especially if the engine gets stuck or the gas pedal is frozen. No, the fault rests squarely on the organizers and promoter of this event, who put innocent bystanders' lives just mere feet from deadly vehicles behind a metal barrier that could barely protect you from a beach volleyball. This was a completely preventable and avoidable tragedy that so many people should have seen coming. When we have monster truck rallies here in the United States, we usually clear out the entire first 20 rows of an arena and have the trucks down below in a dirt area. The people and attendees are hundreds of feet away from the action. Whereas the event in Haaksbergen looked like it took place in a parking lot at the last minute. It is tragic and sad that people had to lose their lives for someone to realize that this was a problem and this was a mistake. The area was too small. There's no way that giant monster truck could have done any of its gigantic maneuvers without running into the barrier. And I dare say that this was inevitable, but it's unfortunate that no one in the event had the foresight to stop it. But you have to wonder, if you were there, in that crowd, would you have spoken up and said, hey, maybe we should move back 20 feet. Maybe these metal barriers aren't going to protect us. I know I might not have, honestly. When you go to something like this and you see this spectacle and you're drawn in by the awe and the awesomeness of everything, you kind of forget, like, oh, wait a second, these people are fallible human beings too. You just assume that the organizers of such an event have taken safety into account and can control their vehicles and know what they're doing. That isn't always the case, though, and a few people died today because of it. It makes me angry and upset, but just sad, generally. And I hope that this occurrence at least educates other people that if you're going to import American monster truck culture into your country, do it right. Do it in a big arena. Do it with safety precautions in place so no one gets hurt. I'd love to hear your thoughts on this story in the comments down below, but for now, that is The World According to Me. My name is Jonathan Paula. Thank you for watching and listening. I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.